Hello everyone, this is Udipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. So we all use the address component inside our Salesforce screen flow. So this video is going to cover all the improved flow address component features. So without any further delay, let's jump to our Summer 24 org and see all this in action. So here I am inside my Salesforce org. First I'll go to my setup, and inside setup I'll type flow and go to my flow section. So inside flow section, I will start creating a new flow, and here I will select start from scratch, next, and a screen flow, create. Now here I will create a screen element, give it a name as screen one, and then here I'll search for address and put the address component. Now after Summer 24, you have the option to, okay, let's give it a name as address, API name address underscore one. Now after Summer 24, you have the option to enable Google Map. So you'll find that option here, show Google Map search field. So you need to add true here. And then in the next option is Google Map search field level. So you can put a level. For example, let me put the level as search in Google Map, and then click on done. Let's save the flow. Let's give it a name as Google Map address, save, activate, and let's run the flow. So once I run the flow, within a minute you will see there will be a option will appear. Yes. Now here we have the option to type the address and automatically Google Map search address will come. And the moment we select one of them, the values like country, street, city, everything will be populated here. So it's a big enhancement in the address component. Another big enhancement that is coming up here. Now after Summer 24, you can make the address field as required. So you have the option required, and if you make it true, then the address field will become required in your screen flow. So now when I'm running the screen flow, you can see the address field became mandatory. So you cannot proceed further without typing an address. The next one that I'll be talking is how to enable the state country pick list. For that, let's go to the setup and type state country. Yep, this one, and you need to basically enable that option. So inside my org, I've already enabled that. So here you'll find the option to enable picklist for address field. Go through the steps 1, 2, 3, and 4, and at the end of the steps, your picklist field for address will be enabled. And once this is enabled, if you open the flow where inside your flow you have an address element, when you run the flow, you will find this option where if you change the country, for example, if I change the country to India, all the states from India will appear here automatically. Similar way, if I, let's say, change of the country to, let's say, Canada, all the provinces from Canada will appear here. So I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon, share, and please subscribe to my channel, so that you come to know about all my upcoming videos. In next few days, I'll be publishing more contents about new features enhancement that are coming up along with Summer 24 release. So highly recommended that you please subscribe to my channel so that you will not miss any new features. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.